Hey there, everybody. Main Surveyor here. FECORE has released the results of its newest microwave test, and I thought that we should go over that today. So, microwave macro errors. And let's come down here. So, what they did was they were in Hungary, and they had two sites. One in, okay, so disclaimer, we're going to do anglicized pronunciations of these towns, so my apologies to anyone in Eastern Europe who can pronounce these properly. So one microwave site was in Pecs, the other in Drebecen, and what they said in a previous release about the microwave test was they weren't going to tell you exactly where these sites were so they could prevent interference. But they do give you a distance at 307 kilometers apart. All right? Fantastic. And then they said that they did this on Friday, September 20th, and that they aligned the antennas for a reference line heading 241 degrees on the Drebecen side and 58 degrees on the Pecs side. Now, those are azimuths, and they said that's according to Google data, and the heading was confirmed by using landmarks from Google Earth and with a compass on the ground. So some red flags should go up there for you right away. Oh, yes, and that they set the vertical alignment to 0 degrees. Now, why would they do that? They did that because they're flat earthers, and we'll see why they shouldn't have set them to 0 degrees in a minute. All right, so let's go over to AutoCAD. Now, Hungary lies in two universal transverse Mercator zones. There's UTM 33N, N for north, and UTM 34N. Okay, and then this is actually UTM 34N, and it covers about a quarter of the globe of its radius there. I'm sorry, of its circumference. So what is it, like 10 million meters? Anyway, so we have Pecs. Now, Pecs is also located in 33N, but since I could find it in 34N, as well as Drebecen, you know, up here at this end, I'm going to use the 34N projection, and I'll tell you why we need a projection to look at this, to analyze their compass directions. Okay, so from Pecs, remember that they said that they had a bearing of 58 degrees, and or an azimuth, sorry, of 58 degrees, and that from Drebecen they did 241. They don't tell you what they really base this on. They don't tell you if they understand magnetic declination or not. So what I did, I went to NOAA has this magnetic field calculator, and you can pick latitude and longitude. So we have Pecs in Hungary, get lat and long, and I did that. And we calculate it, and you can put in the date here. I put in September 20th of this year, and the declination is 4 degrees and 44 minutes east, or we could say round up to 5 degrees. Okay, and then if we were to do Drebecen, get now Drebecen, Hungary, get lat and long, calculate, and it is 5 degrees, 5 minutes, or we'll just say 5 degrees east for that day. All right. Well, actually, that was for the 10th. So let's just make sure we get the right date in there, and it'll still be the same anyway. So 5 degrees, 5 minutes for Drebecen. Okay. Now, what does that mean? That means that if they relied on their magnetic compass to tell them where north was without taking into account the declination, it means that this solid blue line was where they're actually pointed when they said 58 degrees. They were actually pointed 63 degrees from true north, right? And from this one, they actually would have been pointing at 245 degrees, 246 degrees true north. And that's a problem. Right, so they're not even looking close to each other. So if they relied on the magnetic compass without accounting for declination, that's a major problem. Also, if they relied on Google Earth, I'm not really sure why you would rely on Google Earth. You know, I'm in AutoCAD right now, and I placed. Remember how I said they didn't tell us exactly where these towers were, so I just picked a high spot over here in Drebecen. There was a shadow, like there's some kind of point on this building, and I picked over in Pecs by the railroad station. There's some kind of probably a monument there. I just picked that just because it was a nice spot. And so this red line is the line I drew between the two of them. We come over to our properties on the left. We find the length is 307,123 meters, or that rounds to 307 kilometers. They only gave us really two significant digits to work with there. So there we are, right? So we at least have the distance that they requested, that they said that they used, between Drebecen and Pecs. Now, we know that meridians converge, right? So a transverse Mercator map forces meridians to be parallel, but they're not actually parallel in real life. So I don't know if their azimuth is also based on grid north, which this is showing grid north, or if they did it based on true north. So the red line is grid north, and the cyan line here is true north. And the way that I found out the difference between the two was I came over here to this point, come over here to our properties on the left, and it gives us convergence. The convergence is positive 0 degrees, 25 minutes, basically 27 seconds. That means deflecting to the left is where true north is from the grid north. And then if we come over here to Pecs and we select this point that I put on that spot and we look at the convergence, it is negative 1 degree, 59 minutes, 56 seconds. That means we're deflecting to the right of grid north. So the red line is grid north and the cyan line there is true north, so that they converge. So, you know, they have some problems there. They didn't tell us which they based, what they based their work off of. Is it true north? Is it grid north? But they used a compass, so they got really some serious problems there. Okay? They may not have been pointed at each other by quite a bit, is what I'm saying to you. Magnetic compass bearings alone would have been really, really, really goofy. But that's not the only problem, right? So if we go back to their website, it tells us how high each of those towers was. So let's scroll down through here, and it says, I'm scrolling needlessly. I should have just written it down. Okay, well, I did write it down. And at Pecs, they had a tower height of 626 meters. And at Drebecen, they had 169 meters. Well, that's really important. So let's control F. Why didn't I just think of that before? 626. Okay, so on the Pecs side, they had 626 meters, like I said, and Drebecen, 169. They didn't tell us how they determined that. But hey, that's fine. Let's go back to AutoCAD and let's draw the Earth. So actually one other thing that I did was I figured out I used the Earth radius by latitude and I found out the latitude between the two of them. I averaged it to 3,366.5 kilometers. I'm sorry, 6,366.5 kilometers. And so I drew a circle with that radius, so it's all in meters there. That's why it's such a big number. You multiply by 1,000 anyway, and the kilometers by 1,000, you get meters, right, Nathan Oakley? And so I drew these points on the Earth. So we have Pecs here, and then this green line represents the distance over there in the length, the arc length is 307 kilometers. And over here we have Drebecen, we have the tower. I aligned it with the radius there because it's going down the curve. And now it's important to note that they said that the vertical of each of those antennas was set to 0 degrees, which means, I assume, because they don't tell you a whole lot, do they, that it's perpendicular to the tower or to the plumb line at that location, right? And so I've showed that here. The yellow line is the tower, and that red line is the direction of the microwave transmission off of that tower. And that's the same over here. We have the yellow line is the tower, that's 626 meters. And we have we have 90 degrees. Come over here and check the properties. Yep, 0 degrees, 0 minutes, 0 seconds. Okay, so that's, we know that's perpendicular to the plumb line there, to the tower that I've drafted. So we zoom out and we see that, well, it doesn't point on a convex Earth at each tower. We miss, right? We miss by 2 degrees, 45 minutes, 46 seconds. They said that their tolerance was plus or minus 3 degrees. Well, that's under 3 degrees, right? But to be aligned perfectly at each other, let's draw a very nice cyan line directly from the top of this tower, line of sight, because they said it was going to be line of sight, directly to the top of this tower. And, oh, look at that. So the cyan line passes through the Earth. So they couldn't see each other because they passed through the Earth. The Earth was in the way, right? The curvature of the Earth is in the way. And just how much curvature was in the way? Let's just pick a spot where it looks kind of heavy. And, oh, you know, just a 1.4 kilometers, you know. What's 1.4 kilometers between friends? Oh, quite a bit. Keeps your microwaves from hitting each other. Okay, so then what they had assumed was a flat Earth, right? Because they're flat Earthers. They told you by saying they set the vertical of each of the antennas to 0 degrees that, remember vertical angles are zero at horizontal. By setting the vertical of their antennas at 0 degrees, they're telling you they're flat Earthers because they don't think they have to account for curvature, right? So here on the flat Earth, the yellow line is the tower at Pecs, and the red line is what they had set their vertical to, their antenna to, perpendicular to the tower. And we come over to Drebecen, and we see the same thing, the red line. Okay, so what if they had actually set line of sight? Well, I don't know if they were able to set their antenna this tightly, but it should have been 90 degrees, 5 minutes, 7 seconds to be line of sight on a flat Earth to Pecs, which would have to be a little below horizontal at 89, 54, 53. Okay, but the Earth isn't flat, so it didn't work. And just so you see that I have the right distance there, 307 kilometers is that green line. So FECORE proved that the Earth is curved because there is no line of sight between a 626 meter tower in Pecs and a 169 meter tower in Drebecen. There is no line of sight between the two because the curvature of the Earth is in the way. Isn't that just wonderful? Thanks and have a nice day.